Welcome to Disney on Ice!
So we're going to go ahead and check out the rehearsals, get a little sneak peek behind the scenes, talk to the cast and crew members, and maybe learn a few choreography here. So come and let's go check out the rehearsal. TV here at Disney on Ice, Dare to Dream, over here in San Diego. Joining me right now is Jennifer Payne, who's one of the ensembles for tonight's show. Jennifer, thank you so much for joining us this evening. We're so glad to have you here.
Thanks for being here.
You're welcome. Hey, so tell us a little bit about what you'll be doing on the show.
So I'm an ensemble skater, which is kind of great because I get to do something different in all of the storylines in the show. So in each storyline, I get to go out and portray part of the ensemble in that story. Okay. But it's really fun because you get to portray a load of different characters, and you get to really pull from your acting skills and do different things. But I'm also, sometimes I get to host the show. We have a live host in our show. Tonight, I'm actually going to be hosting the show. So it's really fun. We are very interactive with our audience. We really encourage the audience to get up and dance and sing along. And the live host really helps facilitate that. Okay. So it's really fun for me because I love kids. And being on the ice, you know, we don't often get to interact personally with them. So it's a really fun thing that we're bringing to a lot of our ice shows now, where we'll get out into the audience and we'll play with a beach ball during in summer with, you know, Olaf is skating on the ice and talking about how he wants to be in summer. So I bring a beach ball out and we'll throw it around with the audience. Okay. And I start a few dance parties with the kids. And so it's really fun. It's a fun role.
Really we're going to be seeing a lot of her tonight, apparently.
Yes.
So Dare to Dream is the theme. Can you tell us a little bit more about the theme and some of the specific characters we'll probably see?
Sure. So yes, Dare to Dream, a very important message from our show is finding your inner hero, finding your inner strength. And as we go throughout all the different storylines, we see each character from those stories finding their inner strength and their inner hero through whatever circumstances they go through. So get in your seats early because we have a little musical number with a little sing-along with Miguel from Coco.
Okay.
So that's really a great, very popular right now, very fun. So get in your seats early for that. And then we start with a warm-up segment. And that's obviously very important to us. We're athletes, and so being physically fit is very important. And then we move into our Disney movies. So we open with Beauty and the Beast, which is my personal favorite. I love Beauty and the Beast. Yeah. And it's we have a really fun Be Our Guest number. Okay. The costumes are insane. We have giant cakes and cherry pies and cutlery that skates around. We have everything.
Awesome.
So that's really fun. Okay. And then we move on to the Cinderella segment, which is just one of the beautiful classic princesses, obviously. She comes out in this gorgeous carriage, and we have the ball with Prince Charming and the stepsisters trying to win him. And yeah, and then after that, we move on to Rapunzel.
Okay.
So Tangled. And we have an amazing high-flying routine where they fly from her hair.
Oh, my gosh.
It's gorgeous. It's a beautiful silks number.
Okay.
And all of the floating lanterns, of course. And that's just a really fun segment. It's probably my favorite overall segment.
Is that like an aerial kind of thing?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Yes, absolutely.
Okay.
Yeah, so it's really fun. For me, it's my favorite part of the show.
Okay.
So I really like it, and it's very, you know, exciting, and there's this element of thrill with that. And then after intermission, we have Frozen and Moana. So those are both very popular right now.
That's like the end thing right now.
Absolutely. Yeah, we have Anna and Elsa, Kristoff, Olaf, and then in the Moana segment, we have Maui that comes out. And it's really fun to hear the kids sing along. Everybody sings Let It Go, of course.
Yeah.
And we encourage that. We love people to get up and interact with us. And I think we have something for everybody. We have some the more modern Disney princesses like the Frozen family and Moana, Rapunzel, but then we have the more classic ones that, you know, I grew up with, like Belle and Cinderella.
That's awesome. You know, I'm so intrigued and mesmerized by, like, your knowledge behind this. Now I want to get to know you.
Oh, great.
What's your background? How long you've been with Disney on Ice and all that fun stuff?
Sure. Yeah, this is my 11th year with the company. So I've been around for just a little bit.
Yeah, you're a familiar face. I'm sure we all know that.
Yeah.
But that's why I was, like, dying to meet her, because it's just like, oh, my God, I've seen her since I was a kid.
I've been around for a while, but it's fun. We all grew up competitively skating.
Okay.
And then for me, I went to the University of Delaware, and I actually actually majored in figure skating, which sounds fake, but it's real.
There's actually a major in figure skating?
Yes. Wow. Yes. So I did that, and right after I graduated, I applied to Disney on Ice, and they emailed me and said, do you want to go to Japan? And I was like, yes, please. So I've 11 years, 36 countries later, and I'm still loving it, and I've been on several of the different Disney on Ice shows.
Okay.
So it's just really, it's such a fun job. I mean, we get paid to do what we love.
Yeah.
Entertain families and skate.
Yeah.
And we get to do it all dressing up as our favorite Disney characters. So there's nothing better.
That is so awesome. Okay. So do you have any pre-show routines?
Oh.
Are you like one of those
superstitious? I'm not very superstitious. Okay, okay. I think my only thing is I always put my right skate on first and I take it off last. I don't know why.
Just
comfort. But that's not really a superstition,
You'd
I guess.
Amazed. That's actually pretty common. Like when people go to new houses, they're like, put your right foot. I've heard of that.
Oh,
I've
really?
Heard. Okay. So that is a myth, I heard. Okay, so now I've got some fast, fun fact questions if you want to like, answer it right away. Let it go or how far I'll go? Which one do you prefer?
How far I'll go.
Okay. Who gets the most applause aside from Mickey?
Oh, that's hard. Olaf gets a lot of applause.
Really?
Yes, okay, they love Olaf.
Interesting. What's the most, what's your motto?
Oh, my motto. Well, I think our show is called Dare to Dream, and I think that's a pretty great motto. I think that's why we're all here.
2019 theme, right?
Yeah, we all dared to dream, and we, we're here living our dreams, and I think that's important for everybody.
You have a lot of interactions with the fans, so what has been your favorite fan interaction so far?
There was a sweet couple last week, an older couple in gold sequin jackets and shirts, and his said her Mickey and her said his Minnie, and I think they were more excited than any of the kids. And I just had several moments where I interacted specifically with this older couple, and it was just so sweet because I think Disney spans the generations. You have the young ones, the 2 and 3 year olds, which are obviously super adorable as well, but it really is for the whole family.
That's true. Mm-hmm. Especially those generationals that they've been around the longest and they're still coming back. That just
because they love
you.
It Disney is multi-generational, multicultural. I mean, we've performed the show in several different languages, so that's a really cool thing too, to get to hear Let It Go in Spanish or in,
and you can still skate to that.
That's
amazing.
It's great.
Oh my gosh. Okay, now you've toured a lot of cities, but what has been your favorite stop so far?
In my all of my years or this year?
Whatever.
That's a hard one. I think it's like asking somebody to pick their favorite kid, you know, or your favorite food, you know, you have different things that you like for different reasons.
Right.
There's definitely vacation spots that I would go back to, or there's places that I think, oh, maybe I could live there.
Yeah.
I would say on this West Coast tour in particular, I've only been to San Diego one other time, and it was 5 years ago.
Oh.
So this was one of the cities on this tour that I was really excited to come back to.
Awesome.
Because the people are so friendly, the crowds are great,
yeah.
and there's so much good food and entertainment in the city.
Did you see like our place? Like we're surrounded by.
Oh yeah, I just had a yummy brunch this morning too, so I'm loving life here. Yeah.
What can you not live out when you're on tour? Is there something that you have to bring with you? Because you travel a lot.
We do travel. That I would say is a challenging part of our job, is being away from family and friends for special occasions, birthdays, holidays. But our family is here now, and so you kind of make everybody in the group, it becomes your family.
Right.
And so now what's been a really cool thing for me, having been around so long, going on these tours, I'm running into people that I was on tour with 10 years ago in a place that maybe I would never have met up with them again.
Yeah.
So that's just a really unique thing. You have friends and family all over the world. But that's definitely a challenging part of the job. But, you know, thank goodness for FaceTime.
You're in a different technology now.
Absolutely.
Wow. What advice do you have for people who want to get into the skating world?
Oh, do it. It's so much fun. I think have, like I said before, the best job. We get to perform night after night and bring these classic Disney stories to life, but we get to do it skating, which is something that we all grew up loving. And I think skating is just such a beautiful way to express yourself, and it's such a beautiful artistic thing, but as well as athletic. I mean, we have some insane athletes here. You'll see during the Rapunzel segment, like I talked about with the silks routine, and in just all of the numbers in general, it's a very athletic, energetic show.
Yeah.
So I would say do it, get to your local rink and start skating. It's great.
Awesome. Now, Since we're here in Disney on Ice, and if you had to put me in the Disney character, who would you recommend?
Oh my goodness. I would say Moana.
Really?
Yeah, the dark hair.
Awesome.
Yeah.
I love her.
Yeah, definitely.
Okay. So I still have a chance.
Yeah.
I still have a chance. All right. Well, Jennifer, it was such a pleasure meeting you.
Thank you
so much for joining us. Guys, be sure to check out Disney on Ice coming on tour near you, or city near you. And Jennifer, we wish you the best.
Thank you.
Cheers to your success.
Oh, cheers. And get your tickets at DisneyOnIce.com.
That's right. Okay. Thank you so much.
Have a
wonderful day. So it's no surprise that Disney took a leap from the movie screen to the ice ring. With Disney on Ice, dare to dream.
Yes, we can?
Yes.
Okay, great. So I'm going to teach you the haka line from Moana.
Haka line from Moana. All right, so Jennifer's going to teach me some choreography for the show, so I'm really excited.
Yes. Right,
so let's
So in this number, it's the You're Welcome number that Maui sings,
okay.
And his tattoos dance around. And so this is a Polynesian dance,
okay,
basically.
Okay, I can do that.
So you stand really grounded,
yep.
Okay? And you'll put one hand behind your back,
okay.
And one hand out flat like this.
Okay.
Okay,
and this is a full view, right?
The yeah.
Head to bottom, okay.
And then you'll bring your right arm around like this, pull it back,
all right,
and then shoot it forward. And then you'll go up like this,
all right,
like this,
all right,
and then like this.
Guess what? Let's see if I remember that.
Okay, want to do it again?
Yeah, let's do that.
Yeah, ready? Okay. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Okay, let's see if we can do that one
okay,
more time.
Ready? Five, okay. 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1.
I think. What do you guys think? Okay. Do you think I have a chance to be on the show?
I think you're in.
Share your comments online. We'll see how it goes from there. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Dolls dressed in toys. So what's the next logical Disney expansion? How about an ice show?
Step, switch, step, together, step.
Step together, step, switch, step together, step. That's called a kahono. Now you're gonna turn, you're gonna hui. Hui means turn, you're gonna hella. Bend your knees and you're gonna point, 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 and point. Okay, so you're gonna put your feet.
Right.
Keep going,
keep going.
Keep going.
Keep going.
slow down. No one is getting married.
Wait, what?
You can't marry a man you just met.
You can if it's true love.
And what do you know about true love?
not what he says, but remember, you may hear a voice inside. And if the voice starts to whisper, follow the farthest star. One inside is who you are.
It's actually Maui Shapeshifter, demigod of the wind and sea, hero of men. I interrupted.